y'all, and welcome back to my channel. I'm Amber Nicole, and this week I'm giving you 7 tips on how to keep your house clean throughout the week. These 7 things really help me out because I would live a really hectic life because I do have a toddler and she's literally getting into everything always and just making a disaster all the time. This really does help me keep it organized, keep it semi-clean. Like, I do not sweep and mop every single day. I do not go and scrub the bathroom every single day. But I like to think that I have a relatively clean house only because I do all of these things. And these are the tips that help me keep the house clean throughout the week. So tip number 1 is everything literally has a place. Everything. You should not have anything just like random lying around and it not really have a home, is what I like to call it. Our mail, like when we come into the house, we don't just fling it on our little desk. Like, we come over here and put our mail in our little mail cubby. My purse has a place. Addie's backpack has a place. Those hooks are specifically for that stuff. Remotes, coasters, they all go in this little basket right here. They don't go in there. They don't go in there. Right there, that's where they go. Somebody's coming over, or somebody just dropped by unannounced and you were sitting, cuddling, watching Netflix, an easy, hi, how are you? You know, oh, that's great. Yeah, we've been doing this and yada yada, this and that and the other. Blankets, and it's organized. Like, it's pretty self-explanatory. Everything has a place, everything has a home. Find it. If you can't find a home for it or a spot in your house to put something, maybe it's time to get rid of it, or maybe it's time that you just have too much stuff and you don't have room for everything, so get rid of it or prioritize and see what you actually use and what you don't. So speaking of my blanket basket, that leads me to tip number 2, bins and baskets. Now I've said this before on how to like organize your life, but I'm gonna say it again because they're literally a lifesaver. That is my blanket basket. This is like my little charging station. I have all the chargers for like the phones, the Apple Watch, the speakers, all the pens, pencils, everything is here. My vlog stuff goes in there. Let me take you to the bathroom where that is a huge lifesaver. This is his and Addie's for her potty training. Ooh, and trays too. Literally, you can get away with like looking organized if you have a tray. So then we go inside, and literally these are just huge lifesavers. Like, these little separators are literally tampon boxes. I just repurposed them into little organizers. Bins, baskets, and I just bought that one. Definitely go to TJ Maxx or Ross for all of your organizational needs. Bins and baskets literally save your life when you're trying to keep your house organized and clean throughout the week. So going into my next tip, I had mentioned before that if you don't have a place to put something, you don't have space for it or room for it, then maybe it's time to get rid of some things so you can make space for the things that you do use and you do need. That leads me to tip number 3, declutter your life. Throw things out, get rid of things. Having all that clutter just takes up space, takes up your energy, makes the house look messy. Just get rid of it. There's lots of stuff in this house that I would throw away yesterday. Like I've said it before, I'll say it again. My husband is a hoarder and likes to keep random things. Don't ask me why, but even those random things, they have a place for. The moment that we start running out of space for the things that we actually use every day, that's when I'll say, okay, it's time to declutter and throw some things out, because if you don't have space for it, it's time to prioritize. The less that you have, the easier that it is to clean. And I promise, when you declutter your life, it just makes everything so much easier. When everything has a place, boom, at nighttime when you're getting ready for bed, you do like a quick pickup. You're not like stressing like, oh my God, where should I put this? Where does this go? And just like randomly store it somewhere. Like, no, it has a home, it has a place. Go put it in the place and that's it, you're done. If there's anything you take from this video, take this. Declutter your life. It will help you in so many ways, I promise. So my 4th tip to keeping your house clean throughout the week is have a cleaning schedule. I promise, it helps tons, especially if you stick to it. I know there are weeks where you just don't want to do jack shit. Trust me, I know. Let me show you what my cleaning schedule looks like every week. I do a deep clean every single Thursday. I do a midweek clean here. So for my midweek clean, I'll vacuum up all the floors. I will go in and clean the coffee table and Lysol all of Addie's area, cleaning all the kitchen, emptying out the fridge, and doing the laundry. I do all of that on Sunday, along with going grocery shopping, which is why I gotta clean out the fridge. Doing that midweek clean, you know, I'm not mopping, I'm not scrubbing bathrooms, I'm not doing anything major, it's just a cleaning for the week. And I like to do that on Sundays, so that way, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, I'm kind of cool, chilling, you know. On Thursdays is when I do my deep clean, which is scrub the bathrooms, scrub the kitchen, sweep and mop the floors, vacuum the bedrooms, dust the bedrooms, clean up Addie's area, like full on Lysol wipe everything, vacuum up that whole space. That is a Thursday clean. For my everyday cleanup, I pick up all of Addie's toys, I clean the kitchen. Sometimes if the glass table in the living room gets dirty, I will give that a wipe down at the end of the night. Oh, and definitely like make your beds. Like I feel like that's super self-explanatory, but some people really don't make their beds every day. And I'm just not like that, so just make your bed. I put away random things and where they need to go, and that's it. I know some people have work, I know some people have school, I know that, I get that, life happens. Trust me, I know, I'm fully aware of that. Make a schedule that works for you and stick to it. I know that it's tiring. I know I have my days where I'm just like, I don't wanna freaking clean today, or I don't wanna do a midweek clean. Like, I have my lazy days and sometimes I won't do it. Sometimes I'm just like, you know what? I need a break, I'm gonna take a break. And I won't do laundry on Sundays, I'll save it for the next day. Or I won't put the laundry away right away. Or, you know, I get it, I have my days too. But sometimes it's just one of those things that has to be done. So yeah, that is my weekly cleaning schedule. And I highly recommend you all go and figure one out. It will help tons. But that leads me to my next tip, which is tip number 5. And that is cleaning the kitchen every single night. We go back to, I know if you work, if you have school, you have a million kids, and you just had a day, I totally understand that. And sometimes you just don't want to friggin' clean the kitchen after you have dinner. It's happened to me before where I don't clean the kitchen because I'm just like, you know what? I'm gonna save that for tomorrow's problem. And every single time I do that, I regret it 110%. I'm hanging out with Eric and Addie and we're watching movies and or we're just doing whatever. And there are times where I'm just like, I wanna hang out with you guys. I don't wanna be friggin' cleaning. Those are the times where I'm like, I'm not gonna clean, screw this. I'm gonna leave it for tomorrow. I regret it every single time. The morning I'll wake up and my day's already chaotic because I'm like, fuck, I have to clean the kitchen before I can do anything. Once you get in the habit of cleaning your kitchen every single night after dinner, every single night, it's gonna drive you nuts that one time that you don't clean the kitchen and you go to bed, like it's literally gonna drive you crazy the next morning. Clean the kitchen every single night. Even if you have takeout, you're still gonna have to clean something. Like, I'm sure you used a glass or two throughout the day. I'm sure you ate lunch and used a plate or something. If people live in that house, I guarantee there's always something to clean in the kitchen. I guarantee it. Am I the only person that gets stressed out when they have a dirty kitchen? No, I don't think I'm crazy. It's just having a clean kitchen just makes you happy. Like, on God, clean your kitchen and see how happy you get, like, once you're done. So make it a routine. I promise when you wake up the next morning and you wake up to a clean kitchen, you're just like, hey. How's the lighting? Is it better with the light on or off? All right, so my 6th tip for keeping your house clean throughout the week, get one of these vacuums if you have hardwood floors. It's a lifesaver, especially if you have a freaking dog. Oh my God, Molly's hair is ridiculous, okay? We live in an apartment, it's pretty small for the most part, so sweeping wasn't the biggest deal. I'm not really a big fan of sweeping. So the fact that I was having to do it like just about every day in order to make the house look presentable and clean was just, ugh. I hated it, I hated it, I hated it. I went out and found this cutie. It was only like 25 bucks at the PX. One day when we get a bigger house, I will invest in a bougier vacuum. But for right now, being in the apartment, this really does the job.
It just saves me so much time and energy. If I know friends are coming over or whatever, I pull this bad boy out and just do like a quick vacuum all over the house. 10 minutes, it looks like I cleaned all day, but I didn't. Now for our seventh tip, yay.
My seventh tip is candles, wall plugins, in literally every outlet. We also have that bad boy.
I know having plugins can get a little bit pricey with like buying the refills and everything, but honestly, with a dog and a stinky husband, just kidding, he doesn't stink. With a dog, oh my God, the house, like, it would smell so bad. I highly recommend getting something to have the house smell good. We literally have so much stuff that makes the house smell good because Eric and I are both super big on scent. So like, to us, if the house doesn't smell good, then the house is dirty. If you're not really too big on the plugins, there's also like oil diffusers and there's like those little like oil vase things that have like sticks in it. I really don't know what those are called. The Glade plugins are probably my favorite because they're not so expensive. The refills aren't so expensive either. And they do the job. Like, it always smells super good and I like their scents. Whatever you decide to go with, at the end of the day, it still makes your house smell nice. So highly, highly recommend getting scents. As you saw, my candle was on because I have maintenance coming. So I want the house to smell good and look clean. So I did all my steps. I picked up all of Addie's toys, put the blanket away, turned the candle on, boom. House is clean. But yeah, hopefully I was able to help you out and give you some motivation on keeping your house clean throughout the week. All right, and that's the end of our video. Thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell if you want to get notified every time I upload a video. And if you have any tips for me on how to keep my house clean throughout the week, drop them in the comments below. But thanks so much for watching. I'll see y'all next week. Bye.
Adeline, what the hell? Have kids, they said. It'll be fun, they said.